Let's go over the future of Star Wars when it comes to the creators of Game of Thrones and their set of Star Wars movies. This is Mike Zero here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, as you all know, the future of this franchise is very expansive. We have a handful of anthology films in the works, including the Kenobi movie and the Boba Fett film, Rian Johnson's new trilogy, and of course, we have the creators of Game of Thrones and their set of Star Wars movies, which is the subject for today. We have been learning a little bit more, very little, about their set of Star Wars films these past couple of days or so. In fact, Emilia Clarke actually went over not too long ago that their Star Wars movies will be Star Wars on acid. We also learned that it's going to be catered to adults and be a very violent set of Star Wars movies. So that's really great to hear, honestly. I think that that is something that a lot of fans have been wanting to see when it comes to this franchise. But looking at the one update that we do have for the set of Star Wars films by the creators of Game of Thrones is that a handful of cast members from Game of Thrones will be involved in their projects. Now, this of course means different actors and actresses that work for the HBO hit series Game of Thrones. So for all we know, we could very well have Peter Dinklage, Lena Headey, Kit Harington, Sophie Turner, you know, maybe even, Ian Glen or Alfie Allen. There's tons of possibilities of different actors and actresses that could very well be involved in this movie or set of Star Wars movies. Now, do you guys see this as either a good or a bad thing? Now, so far, they have been putting some Game of Thrones actresses in the Star Wars franchise, such as, of course, Gwendolyn Christie as Captain Phasma, or, of course, Emilia Clarke as Kira in the Solo A Star Wars Story movie. And now they're looking at a group, a whole entire group of actors and actresses that worked on the HBO hit series Game of Thrones to be involved in these new set of Star Wars movies. Now, it really does make one wonder exactly what will their movies entail. I honestly do believe that this also, once again, screams the Old Republic. It seems like they're really trying to capture that Game of Thrones feel. And if you look at the Old Republic, guys, if you look at a lot of material for that era of Star Wars, it really does have a medieval theme to it. And that is something that both Disney and Lucasfilm are embracing with the sequel trilogy, is of course that medieval tone to the background of it all. And looking at these new set of Star Wars films that will be created by them, I think it's going to be the Old Republic. If not the Old Republic, it could be something completely unexpected, maybe even an era before the events of the prequel trilogy, like right just before that part. Maybe even the life of Palpatine and Darth Plagueis, etc. Now, I've gone over that before in the past. I think I've always wanted to see a young Palpatine, you know, pretty much being trained by Darth Plagueis, and how Palpatine became Palpatine essentially before Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace. The other factor that I would like to see is maybe a movie in which, you know, Palpatine is training Darth Maul. When I look at the prequel trilogy, there are moments where you can kind of tell where they could definitely expand off of by using certain pieces of dialogue. Like in The Phantom Menace, you know, Palpatine tells Darth Maul, you know, you've been trained very well, they will be no match for you. If they were to make a story about Palpatine being trained by Plagueis and Palpatine training Maul eventually, that piece of dialogue would mean a whole lot more. The same goes for when Yoda tells Obi-Wan Kenobi at the very end of Revenge of the Sith that he has training for him to do on Tatooine to commune with his old master Qui-Gon. That, to me, that line of dialogue is a perfect connection to the Obi-Wan Kenobi Star Wars movie. So, looking at the creators of Game of Thrones and their set of Star Wars movies, I honestly think it's a good thing to include a handful of actors and actresses from the HBO hit series Game of Thrones, because if they're really trying to capture the Old Republic as an era for the new Star Wars franchise, I think the Game of Thrones cast is a perfect decision to throw into there. But anyways, guys, what do you think about this? Is this a good or a bad thing for the new Star Wars movies to come by the creators of that series? Drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about that. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.